Hello everyone, so today we're gonna make a wild mushroom risotto. Well, every time I say today, but it's one day where we're doing lots of recipes. So we are a bit tired now. So I think we're gonna have a bit of red wine, John.
Yes.
Shall we do that?
Yes.
Okay. So that's not for our recipe, that's for a little compensation. Cheers.
Cheers.
Nice and fruity. Okay, today we're gonna make a wild mushroom risotto. So in October, it's the time to buy all the wild mushroom where they are cheapest on the market. So I'm buying lots and then I clean them and freeze them. So they are frozen. So we have black trompette de la mort. Beautiful, stay crunchy when it's cooked. The chanterelle, which is an amazing flavor. And the girole, little yellow ones. So it doesn't affect much when you cook them. Maybe they're very watery, but it's okay. You just cook it, reduce it, and it come up like fresh, really. That's fine. Okay, so we need... Oh, that red wine. That's a bad idea. One onion. I'm gonna start with one onion. And we're gonna pan fry our little wild mushroom. Yeah. Oh. I can't peel my onion now. I just can't peel my onion. Okay, there we go. He doesn't want to peel. Okay. Then, a bit of garlic, maybe two bulbs. I think it's that knife. I'm not used to this knife. That's better. Okay. So just get two bulbs of garlic, yeah. Remove the inside germ. Always. Up. Oh, this onion is strong again. We're all gonna cry in a minute. Okay, let's turn on the pan. A bit of extra virgin oil. And a little bit of butter. There. Well, we're gonna slice up our garlic very fine. And then our onion as well. Let's make it like little squares of onions. That will do. A bit more. There we go. Perfect. So now we're gonna put our onion. Finely chopped. Half of the garlic we chopped. Because some of the rice, we're gonna cook it with some mushroom. And another pan, just mushroom with garlic seasoned. Just to finish it off the risotto at the end. Okay. Here we cry. Okay. So let's put a bit of black trumpet. Our chanterelle. Alors girolle. Let's cook all that together. In this pan, we're just gonna cook the rest of the mushroom with a bit of garlic. And I like a little touch of butter already. Okay, garlic first. And straight the mushroom. Seasoning. Seasoning in the other one. Okay. That's gonna cook gently. So now here, the onion is cooked, the mushroom as well. So we're gonna start to put our rice, risotto rice. So for one person, for a starter size, maybe 150 grams per person. I just guessed by eyes already. Something like that. Let's eat it up our rice. I can add a bit more butter at this stage. Nice. There's enough garlic, onion, it's good. Bit more rice. Voilà. Then we have a chicken stock. So chicken stock, I'm not sure if you can buy it, but this one, it's made with chicken bones. Okay, so in a big pot, you put chicken bones, it's free from the butcher, fill up with water, put one onion, one leek, maybe a little bit of carrot, and then boil it, bay leaves, thyme, peppercorn, and you boil it gently, you know, a very slow boil. And then you drain everything out after 5 hours of little boiling. And you make your chicken stock. Or you can do a beautiful chicken broth with a tiny pasta as a soup, eating ravioli, tortellini. It's perfect. So now we're gonna deglaze our rice with the chicken stock. Little bit. Little bit by little bit. So we put a little bit of chicken stock, let it reduce, put more, let it reduce until your rice is gonna be cooked. But for risotto, you want a kind of crunchy rice, a little bit in the middle. So don't cook it very, be carefully. Voilà. Gently. Voilà, it's all reduced now. I can put another ladle of stock. Etc, etc, etc. I will adjust the seasoning at the end, okay? So now it's reduced again. Before to add more stock, I might put some, let's don't be confused, white wine. Voilà. I will lift up all the flavors. And a bit more stock. We're gonna try the seasoning. Okay, let's put some seasoning. You might hear a bit of a grazing noise. That's because of the induction, it picked up on the microphone. So sorry about that. Okay, a bit of more seasoning. Let's try. Okay, a bit more stock. Really have to stay next to it, really, because it's quite fast to do. Maybe we're gonna finish it on the stove there. Up. Well, let's finish it here. You might have think that we the size grown up, but we've changed it in between because it got caught at the bottom. So that's why you really have to stay next to it. But it's nice to do. Let's have some more. It's okay, it's cooking. We're here. Bit more stock. Yeah. That's cool. A bit more stock. Let's do it. Let's try. No, we're fine. Drink it with moderation. Okay, so this is done, I think. Let's see, let's see. Yeah, the rice is cooked all around, slightly crunchy in the middle. It's still quite runny. Yeah, is what you want. So, at this stage, we're just gonna finish just a little bit. Voilà. So usually people using mascarpone, get out. Lovely red wine. no, usually people using mascarpone to finish it and glaze it. We can use as well a bit of cream. A bit of cream up. Nice. With a little bit of grated Parmigiano. Voilà, that's enough. If it dry too much, add a bit of water or a bit of stock. Voilà. A plate, we need a plate. There we are, a little risotto for starter, beautiful. Then we can put a little bit of Parmigiano shaving. Oh dear. Oh dear, that's the red wine. Voilà. Okay, let's try it. A bit of my favorite. Little crunch, this Parmigiano cheese. It's very nice. I love risotto. That's all. Thank you.